welcome to another cabinet vision tutorial. My name's Tayla, and today we're going to be looking at a design tip, specifically how to move peninsula walls side to side when it comes to island benches. In this example kitchen here, you can see that the island bench is sitting in line with the corner of this wall here, but it's 600 millimeters from the edge of the back wall of cupboards here. So in this example, what we want to do is move the island 300 millimeters to the left so that it ends up being centered to that back wall of cupboards. The easiest, quickest, and best way to do this is by moving the peninsula wall itself rather than by extending and reducing the size of the wall. But by moving the peninsula wall side to side can be a little bit tricky, so I'm going to show you how to do it. To do it, we need to use this center box on the wall itself. If we click on that, you can see it comes up on this top left-hand side with mid X and mid Y values. So if I just hit escape and click on that wall again from fresh, you can see the mid X is negative 1005.4 and mid Y is 898.4. First of all, we might have a question of what is that in relation to. If I turn on the snap to grid, you can see there's this light blue coming down and across through the page. Basically, that is the center of the page's axis. And if we were to move the island to be aligned with that, you can see the mid X and mid Y become zero. So that's what it's in relation to. Again, I'm just going to hit escape and turn off that grid for now. So if I click on that center, you can see if I move my island, if I just hover my mouse out to the left, the direction that I want to go, you can see that mid X number has become a bigger negative number. So if I move it the other way, you can see it becomes a positive number. So if I go right back to the center where I picked it up from, what I want to do is get into that mid X value and I want to minus 300 millimeters to move it to the left by 300 millimeters. To do that, the best way is to hit tab, because if I move my mouse to click up there, it's going to change the values. So if I hit tab and then hit the arrow button on my keyboard to get to the end, and then I type in minus 300 and hit enter, that will move my wall and everything that is attached to my wall all together 300 millimeters to the left. And now if I throw some dimensions on my page, you can see that this island is now centered to the back wall, 300 millimeters from each side. So that's a really easy and quick way to move your island. It can take a little bit of practice to become familiar with using those X and Y values. So if you've got an island or a peninsula wall, just again, click on that center, move it in and out, have a play. You can hit escape to let go. It's super easy to use. If you have any questions or comments about using this in your projects, please let us know by leaving them below, and I hope you have a beautiful day.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a cabinet vision power user.